So greetings everybody, welcome back to the castles of Dr. Creep. And now, we're finally going to play a level that doesn't suck. I cannot believe we eventually got there, but here it is. But unfortunately, this castle also happens to be one hard son of a bitch, so this is why I'm gonna put unlimited lives on, because, well, this is like my fourth attempt at recording this level, and frankly, well, I don't feel like having a fifth time, so sorry for those of you who wanted a manly three lives run out of a puzzle game. That will teach you. Okay. So now we're playing Rittenhouse, and like I've already just said, this is the hardest castle of the entire game, without any doubt. But at least it's a pretty fun one, but yeah, as you've seen, this is also a castle which also relies on repetition quite a lot. But at least it's not as dreary or tedious as it was in, say, Baskerville and Romania, although, well, we're gonna have to go through this room multiple times so that we can shut off all of these conveyor belts that you're seeing scattered all around, protecting the yellow key that we need in order to finish the level. At least we already know that there's a pretty definite handout of this whole level. Unlike some levels where you pretty much will just wander around and just think, hey, it probably would take me less time to die in real life than to even beat this castle at all in the first place. So don't worry, this castle at least is not dirty. But yeah, there are some rooms which are going to be pretty nasty. We're gonna have to turn off the trapdoor which is above us before we can do something about it though. But I'm gonna come back to it pretty soon, and this room is probably one of the reasons why I even decided to turn on unlimited lives in the first place. Because this castle is just mean. And you've probably figured at this point that, well, this level is probably, well, it's pretty much a cousin of Alternation, except that, well, it's a bigger, much meaner cousin, which is a shitload harder, as I've already told, but hey, at least the level is a whole lot more nicer and more interesting. I gotta say, this level has some pretty interesting rooms and challenges. The only thing that I really wouldn't like about it is the fact that there's just so many of these recurring puzzles. But not too many, but the few of them that it has are just incredibly... Well, they're just incredibly incredible. Let's just leave it at that. I'm pretty sure you'll have an idea to make of yourself beside, well, recurring puzzles are just a part of this game, but some of them probably could have used just a little bit of shortening, and holy shit, the guy who made the game really likes conveyor belts a lot. Case in point. So yeah, the switch to turn off the conveyor belt on the top is right in front of us, but we're gonna have to turn off all of the lightning machines first. But at least once this conveyor belt will be shut down, it will be shut down. We won't have to redo this puzzle a million times, although, well, this is one room that we're still going to visit many, many times. But yeah, this room is also a reason why I decided to have unlimited lives on, because, well, this room made me scrap my two previous attempts at doing this video, so that should speak to how much volumes. Oh great, am I even going to make it out of here in time? Oh, just barely, just because I decided to get stuck in the ladder. But yeah, as you probably figured out, there's no way to get to the other end in time with all of the conveyor belts shut down, so it's obvious as what do we need to do. Yeah, we need to have a little help from them by going forward like this. The timing that you need in order to flip all of them correctly is just incredibly... You just need some incredible timing in order to be able to do that, because the buttons are really, really touchy. And this room right here, yeah, it's also a pretty interesting challenge that is probably going to kill you if you don't stop here for a second to think about it. You can already tell that the trapdoors are going to open up the one trapdoor which is just above of it, but... Well, what about the ones which have no trapdoor just above them? Well, they open up the way to the exit room, obviously. Because we need to make it sure so that we can exit this room by taking care of the two trapdoors that are just in front of it. But yeah, if you don't do it, well, Obviously, you're just gonna have to wait for your dad because no one is going to be rescuing you from here. Absolutely none. So you have a pretty much an idea of what kind of things that you have to do every single time that you go into this room. We're gonna have to work our way up the trapdoor chain so that we can eventually turn off the conveyor belt that is at the top of the room, allowing us access to the other part of the half of this level, because just like Alternation, this level is separated into two halves. And we're gonna have to visit them both so that we can clear the way so that we can eventually get access to the key, as well as the other room with the ray gun that you saw earlier. But we're going to save that until quite a lot of time. In the meantime, we're just gonna have to see what we're gonna have to do. And well, in the meantime, I'm also just going to cut all of this backtracking and clearing out of the room so that next time that we zoom in, we'll finally have access to the other room. So we're finally back, and this time we can finally clear the way forward in order to get access to the next room, because we've just cleared every single one of these trapdoors through multiple visits, and now we can clear the two ones that lead to the conveyor belt that we need to switch off. Just like this. So yeah, even though that puzzle really seemed a whole lot daunting, it's really not that hard, but yeah, it's just a little bit time consuming, but it's still pretty tame compared to some of the other puzzles that will hook you into this level, and right now I couldn't pick a worse spot to stand in. And right now we're just gonna have to wait until the gun gets down here, because we're gonna have to come up many times, but if we keep the gun low enough like this, we're never gonna have to fiddle with the gun controls again. As a good old saying says, fiddle with a gun control for a day, and you'll feed it for a year. No wait, that thing is about fish. Oh boy. Way to get mixed up once again. But hey, obviously enough, ray guns are all about fish. Or so did I read. So goodbye, you wonderful dim-witted cousin, who are still smarter than me because, well, unlike the rest of, unlike me, well, you do not wear a pink shirt, so this is why you're one step superior. Yeah, those Frankensteins are just so badass, walking around like they don't give a shit. Or maybe... So now we're finally going to be able to get access to another part, and obviously, we're never going to be able to return. But yeah, see how much the gun is moving every single time we go through this room. Oh, yeah, I really, really like this room. It's pretty much a relic from Baskerville that we're seeing here. A puzzle that we're gonna have to do every single time that we go into this room, and obviously enough, well, it wouldn't be a dreary puzzle if they didn't make you cycle through all of the colors every single time, because yeah, you have to do this every single time. They couldn't even make it so that all of the colors could be accessible really quickly, no. You have to go through all of the colors of the rainbow before you can finally get to your silver lining. Yeah, we're gonna have to do this every single time we go into this room, but hey, at least we don't have to go there a whole lot, so yeah, it's not as bad as it seems. It's not like Baskerville, and it's not the right button. We still need to go one floor up. So yeah, while most of the castles seem, well, it seemed to be having a good mix of difficulty and everything, well, this is going to change pretty much into the upcoming three rooms. Unfortunately, this is where Rittenhouse kind of falters for a second, because, well, you will just see. Some things are better be seen than be explained, especially since you don't have the whole gist of it yet. Because the thing that I've just did right here, minus the switching of colors, we're gonna have to go through this multiple times, but You still have to get the whole grasp of how much time we're going to be able to do this, but hey, at least we finally have one other switch out of the way. So that whenever we'll be back from the hand trends of the second half, we'll be able to get access to this other button, but in the meantime, we're gonna have to take care of the other room. While having an avant-garde concerto of teleporter vomiting into the heather. That really sounds like an awesome name for a composition. So yeah, we're gonna have to go through this room multiple times so that we eventually get access to the red key, so without any further ado. Almost there! So close, but yet so far, because unfortunately our guy just cannot seem to get the required physical effort to climb up a pole like that. Instead, well, we're going to be able to make some more teleporter music. We're like a Beethoven in the making right here. An unintentional Beethoven, but hey, what do you know? You missed a note there, champ. So you're gonna have to do all of your sonates in order to get ready for your musical teachings. So here we go, we have the red key, and at this point you will be thinking, alright, we're finally done with this. No, not quite, but let's not get ahead, because we're going to see what the other room looks like. And before you go into this room, don't forget to do that. You will see why. Yep. Because it is not over yet. It's never over. You can never succumb to easiness, because, well, at this stage of the game, you really shouldn't expect anything easy. But this is why you make it so that this one thing also gets close, because, well, this is also another thing which happened to kill me, because, well, you know, I was just so much in a hurry that I will storm into the other room while not taking the time to close that machine, and this made me lose my last life, and that I had to just restart everything. And now, well, we're just gonna have to go through all of this room so that we get another key for the next door. Two keys in two different rooms that we need to use in the very room where you picked them. Well, you don't really get that room until the next door, but hey, that's still close enough. So yeah, don't worry, we wouldn't miss that whole concerto thing yet. It's not time for a farewell yet, but well, in the meantime, we're pretty much just going to edit all of this so that, well, you're not gonna have to see all of this. So, without any further ado, let's storm into the green room and say goodbye for now. Hey, welcome back! Guess what I did again? Forgetting to flip that switch, obviously! So, yeah. That was one of the main reasons why I forgot. That was the same exact reason why I scrapped the last video. I can't believe I did it again, but hey, what do you know? We always need a little bit of unintentional humor into those videos. No one is allergic to failure. Why the hell am I not cutting this again? Oh boy. But hey, at least you can say that this tragedy at least had some kind of silver lining to it, because hey, what do you know, we're gonna have to come to this room again one less time, because the next time that we come back to it, the way to the yellow key will finally be open and we're going to be able to... okay, why did I do that again? Oh my god, why am I such an idiot? So yeah, I really didn't make much of a bad move when I turned on infinite lives after all, so okay, time to cut that again. Okay, now do it as I say. Like this. Good job. Alright, just look at all of the fun times we had trying to get this key, but the time to reap our reward has finally come. after being an horrendous idiot and failing in the most catastrophic way possible. Hey, what do you know? Retards still deserve victories. It felt such like a poignant phrase. Or phrase, as you want to say it, but... anyway. Yeah, we finally have the blue key, so that means we're going to be able to get back to wherever we needed to go. Yeah, and this time I also didn't forget about flipping the button too, so... hooray for me, I finally did things the correct way. And hopefully that winning streak will continue later on, as we're going to tackle the other half of the level. Because there's now no way to avoid not going into it, because, well, you'll see why. This is not Alternation's bigger cousin for no reason. And this is also why you made it so that the top and the bottom lightning machines were switched off, by the way. We don't need to worry about the middle part yet. So, yeah, that's the reason why. It also opens up stuff like that. And obviously there's no reason to ever go back up, so it's time to tackle another sinister part of the castle. The second half of Rittenhouse. But from what I remember of it, I pretty much think that the other half of the level was a whole lot more fun, so... hey, at least this will be it. Oh, I really enjoyed this room, but, oh god, I don't enjoy the fact that we're gonna have to go through black rooms again. This is really, really nasty. So, yeah, first of all, the first thing that we need to do into this room is just gain access to the green key, which is pretty much a giveaway. In fact, I don't even know why there's even a gray teleporter here, considering that, well, the brown teleporter here will always allow you to go into the top part of the castle and everything. So, congratulations, this whole part is worthless. In the meantime, we're gonna have to go to a part which is not worthless. So, oh great. Yeah, it couldn't be a cousin of Alternation without having a black room too. You're probably already shivering in terror, but... guess what? This puzzle is actually not bullshit for a chain. Well, this is still a puzzle which requires trial and error, but hey, at least this is one that cannot kill you. And well, this one is pretty easy at least, because well, all of the things alternate, so basically the first thing is wrong, so you just need to make it so that you have to go up and down, and well, this will work, because you've just noticed that if you don't take the right path, you're just going to be stopped into your track by another... oh, yeah. I don't even know why I'm doing that, but hey, what do you know? I'm gonna do it anyway because I can. But then again, what I'm doing right now is completely worthless, because you can just go to the brown thing and just teleport there instantly, which takes even less time. But what do you know? I'm a fan of impractical solutions. So yeah, if you don't take the right path, there's just going to be a trapdoor blocking your way, but the way that we've just did it, there's nothing bad which is going to happen to us. So yeah, as much as this castle, the rest of this castle is harder, the black room of this level was far easier than the one in Alternation. So congratulations on not making sense, I guess. But hey, whatever. I'm gonna take this... oh great. In all of my distraction, I didn't even notice that this gun was shooting at me. I wonder how the hell I even got alive. So yeah, once again, this is a recurring puzzle that really outlasts its welcome, because you have to do it way too many times, and well, you still need to cycle through all of these rooms, but hey, at least the journey back is a whole lot easier. And you still can make some pretty merry melodies. So anyway, time to just cut off a whole chunk of backtracking, because we're gonna have to eventually turn off all of the trapdoors. Basically, on every single visit, we're gonna have to go through another place. In fact, I'm just going to show you what it just did, because, well, you've seen. There's absolutely no way cleared, but, well, we're going to clear one, because this is how this level works. basically, yeah, the teleporter in which you teleport in just clears the thing which will normally block your way. So this is how it works. And now, the way that this is going to work is with a pause button and a resume button. So, we meet again, little Raygun, and this time I'm gonna have to dispose of you really, really high in the sky. Even though that later on I'm gonna have to bring you all the way down, just for the sake of backtracking, because we're obviously gonna have to do that a whole lot yet again. So basically, once that you've done that, we can finally shut off this machine, which allows us access to, well, the conveyor belt that we need to switch off to gain access to the other half of the level, but hey, what do you know, we still need to backtrack again. Oh hey, did I really talk about backtracking? Oh boy, how silly am I. I should deserve an award for my lack of shortcoming. No, a lack of shortcoming will mean that I will be able to figure out things in advance. So, good job on me being a moron. So, like I've just did with the other room, I'm just going to just send this gun all the way down here so that it's not going to bother anyone. And, well, I just put the conveyor belt to go into that direction because, once again, this is going to be a one-way trip because of the way in which you'll eventually see how the other room feels like. So basically, I'm just speeding myself up by doing what I just did. We're gonna fly through this room and make it so that no gun will ever be able to shoot us down. Because there's certainly no quick draws. And we also get access to the green room by going there. And we still can't do anything yet because we're like into the other place, we still need to... Into the other half of the level, we're gonna have to trigger the other thing that we need to have triggered before we can do anything. So in the meantime, woo! I'm a human blur, a pink human blur. Yeah, you can beat the mummies on your unfastness this time around, but don't think it will be as easy on your other visits. So is it high enough? Obviously not. Still a level up and we'll eventually be able to do something. Yeah, and obviously, once we'll be able to shut that down, obviously there's no way to get down here again, considering how little the ledge here, so there's no way to avoid the other mummy back down, so this is why it's a one-way trip. Holy shit, they just can't get enough of conveyor belts. This is the official conveyor belt level. So, we're gonna have to turn this one by one and avoid the mummies that surface. Basically, there's no way to do this outside the teleporter, so we're gonna have to shut that down one at a time. In fact, there's going to be a lot of recurring puzzles, but hey, at least we can do all of them at once. So, talk about being nice for a change. They really thought about everything. Okay, or almost everything, because you're gonna have to make a choice. And yeah, I'm going to do this puzzle first. Considering that we're going to be done with it fairly fast. So you've already figured out what you need to do with the Frankenstein. They have an appointment with a doorbell. And yeah, it's a little bit tricky to trap them properly because, yeah, this sort of thing happens. So, hey, what do you know? You just need to do that and, well... They're just going to be eventually trapped and be able to finally do mentoring into their little refined corner, where they can appreciate the art of walking around in circles. So, might as well pay a visit to the other room while we're around. Yeah, we're gonna have some more Frankenstein fun here by frying them as well and avoiding them sliding on poles. We could already do this if we want, but, well, what do you know, I'm just going to do this first. Considering that there's pretty much no penalty on doing the other puzzle or anything right ahead of time, so we're gonna cut down every single one of these conveyor belts, but obviously enough, we're not gonna cut off the red one yet until we figured out how to go through every single one of these puzzles, because otherwise we're never going to be able to come back up here, and that means we will never be able to eventually get back to the central room of the level alive. Well, that wouldn't be an issue if you had unlimited lives, but well, I'll just assume I don't have infinite lives. And it starts becoming pretty tricky to time the force field correctly to shut down on both Frankenstein at once, so this is where the puzzle gets a little bit tricky. So hey, at least they find a way to keep things interesting. The puzzles are not always as easy as you think they will be. No, mister. So yeah, what happened to me editing things? I don't know, I guess I'm enjoying the way the level is being played right now, but I'm certainly going to cut off the other room because this is where there's going to be a whole lot of backtracking and, well, there's still the timing and all of the finesse that is required for you to be a good Frankenstein trapper. Because now we have all three of them to deal with, and that's not going to be as simple this time around, so let's see if I'm a quick draw. Yeah, they just keep bouncing around, and that just makes it so that I have absolutely no idea how to even time that. Oh well, I'm just going to cross my... Ow, what a jerk you are! Yeah, if this takes too long, I'm just going to cut that out because, yeah, I figure that no one wants to see me trap Frankensteins for hours, but hey, what do you know? Whenever you always talk about cutting out your failures, you succeed! This is the beauty of things. So, oh yeah, that's right. We still have to do another visit into the other room. And basically, on my next visit through this room, I'm going to showcase what I need to do onto the Frankenstein Blue Room. And this is a room which I can safely cut without you missing anything. So, without any further ado, we're going to clear this room and get access to the other one. Oh jeez, that's right, you still need to go there, but hey, whatever. I'm going to go through this room yet, so just so you can see, because we're still gonna have to shut down this trapdoor too, but I'm going to do that off camera. So, it's a mighty chase to the electric fence. Who will win? Congratulations, Frankenstein! You are stupid enough to walk on electricity. How proud you are. So yeah, I'm pretty much going to cut off everything at this point. I'm going to trigger this trapdoor right here, which will clear the trapdoor, which is down. And I'm going to kill off all of the Frankensteins later. Welcome to the most sadistic display of violence in this entire LP so far. Notice, a sad moment of cruelty as many poor brain-witted monsters are going to be taken away by electricity. Let's spare a minute of silence for the sadly departed. And yeah, those Frankensteins and mummies surely were upholding to it, considering that these guys probably can't even speak in the first place. Besides, the mere effort of walking back and forth is just making it so that they just can't have any thoughts. Yeah, they look so poor into that cell. Maybe I shall free them whenever I'll be absolutely sure that I'm not ever gonna have to go back up here. And well, this moment will happen right now. Because you need to shut off this conveyor belt before we're even able to start shutting down all of the things. Basically, the yellow thing will bring us back to the beginning room. And this is where we need to go, but... Oh, there's a force field blocking the way, so... Yeah. We did an entire circle around the second half of the level, and we couldn't even shut down any single trapdoor. And now, we're gonna have to... to have an adjourned meeting in order to eventually be able to do something with the green room. In the meantime, we're gonna go back on the first half of the level so that, well, we can finally shut down the conveyor belt, considering that we can do it ahead of time since, well, you know, we died in the most stupid way earlier. So anyway, I'll be right back. It was a long, imperious walk through the wintry halls of Rittenhouse, as a conveyor belt is finally turned off. Although, yeah, this entire half of the level is now completely done, but on the flip side, there's not even a single switch which has been pressed onto the other one. Like alternation, this bit of the castle is kinda not balanced properly, but anyway, backtracking time! Alright, Frankensteins, the time for you has come. You are now grown. You have a mental age of about 5, and it is finally time for you to experience freedom. Have fun. Oh, look at them go, they're so cute. They're absolutely so cute. God, no, get away from me! Okay, they're cute, but they're very deadly. So, yeah, we could safely do that, even though that achieved absolutely no purpose, considering that we're never gonna go up here ever again. We can finally stop using the teleporter that goes to the orange teleporter, whatever color it is. I think it's more light brown, but it's now time to shut off the final conveyor belt. And soon enough, we're finally going to be able to witness an entire room of conveyor belt that is just batting in silence. Here we go. Ah, Jesus Christ, that jerk up here is just spoiling such a happy scene. Such a happy scene of tranquility, and this jerk is just hyperactive and wanting to hug people frenetically. Ugh. Those monsters really have a huge lack of affection. Poor bastards. So good news, we can finally do something. But the bad news is, we're still gonna have to... okay. For some second, I really thought they were down here and I was wondering why, but here we go. Those Frankensteins. The entire domain belongs to them. They finally earned their freedom. They were worthy enough. They've run enough laps to be a football player one day. And it's also going to be time to be a football player because, well, in order to be able to continue, well, clearing the room in order to flip off all of the trapdoors in the green room, yep, you've guessed right, we're gonna have to backtrack to the first half of the level again, even though everything is cleared. Yeah. Just like in alternation, this is a part of the level which clearly needs work because the left half of the level takes a whole lot less time to go through than the second one. And it's a shame because the second half of the level, I really think it's a lot better. But alright, time to see you. Alright, let's say hi to a bunch of ungrateful jerks who didn't forget about us. And I was telling you that this room was not going to be as... smooth sailing the other times that we will go through, well, I have to prove positive right here. Yeah, because those jerks also want to hug you, but their ways of loving you involve choking you to death violently, so I'm sorry, but I have absolutely no time to play with you. So, alright, only one more thing to flip and we'll finally be done with the running around the entire castle part of the level in order to move on to what is probably the most challenging room of the entire game, and unfortunately we cannot run back down because there's no way to avoid the mummy here. So here we go, time to flip the last switch. Without any further fanfare. Ding 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 ding. Okay. That wasn't the best fanfare ever, but we'll deal with it. So, here we go, we can finally start tackling the hand part of the level, now that both of the ways into the into the room with all of the conveyor belts, and the one with the ray gun are open, so we're just going to zoom all the way back to the beginning room so that we can tackle the ending of the level. Okay, time for the ending. And, well, it turned out that, well, the designer of this game decided to keep the last part of the level. Well, the last part of the level should be the hardest one, and, well, it really is. First of all, first thing that we need to do is to flip the switches this way, because now we're gonna use the middle walkways that are around the level, instead of going from the top to the bottom like we always used to. This time, this is where the switches that you saw 45 minutes earlier finally have a use. So here we go. It's now time to enter what is probably the hardest room of the entire game. But if you play the level on two players, this is a room which is a lot easier, but well, this is still one hell of a bastard of a room, because this is where the gun placement is just or my sheer stupidity. Now it's not even like I can die. I'm shielded from my awful situation just beneath this gun, so okay, time to retry this again. Yep, I really did a good move by having unlimited lives on. Absolutely. Because I never knew when such feats of stupidity will strike, especially this late. At the part where you shall not expect to be stupid at all, because this one room alone can just completely ruin your day. Because this gun has about a 50-50% chance of killing you upon sliding down that pole. I'm hoping that, well, on one of our visits to the room, we'll eventually see it, because, well, this room is just a huge heap of bullshit, because sometime you'll slide and you live, and sometime you'll slide and you die. And this is where you need to find out another alternate way to make it so that, well, you're going to make it through the room with the guarantee of living, and there's a way to do this, but it's also pretty tricky to pull off. But right now, yes, we can finally flip one out of, yeah, there are six conveyor belts that we need to switch off, so we're gonna have to go to this room 7 times before we'll finally be done. And this implies also that we need to survive through the carnage of the Raygun room, which is onto the other side. Basically, we're just gonna have to cycle around those rooms. And I'm still going to leave at least one take in, just so you can see if the other room is going to fuck me up or not, because, well, it's... Because, well, you really need to see why the green room is such a bitch, like I advertised, because I made it look so easy. Well, I really just got lucky, but alright, we'll see here. Let's see if we'll be as good. Okay, so apparently now the gun has decided to be really kind to me. So, alright, it's time to cut that out. Okay, now I've pretty much made this puzzle harder all by myself. Okay, now that wasn't the fault of the room. But I swear that at one time this room is eventually going to screw me over. but hopefully it won't be into this one fashion, because holy shit. That pretty much was the most embarrassing way I could ever go. Doing that. This is not the way to go neither. This is a dead end. And this is a way which kills you. This is not how dead end works. But now I assume that now I've decided to just go around and offer live commentary that this is the time where it will fuck. Yeah, here we go! We finally seen that happen. It just needed an unfortunate accident for the level to finally become dickish. But hey, I got quite a good streak because I managed to flip off something like 4 of the 6 conveyor belts before Delaval decided to finally screw me over, so I'm wondering if it's just me being incredibly unlucky or if it's just Delaval's fault has been advertised. But anyway, there's a foolproof way that you can make it so that you'll never be killed by the gun, but it's still not pretty easy at worst. Yeah, first of all, we're gonna have to lower this gun right here, because this is part of succeeding. Lower and lower is the motto of the day. Yeah, the gun needs to be low because we're gonna have to work with the force field in order to be able to do this. Okay, this is not how you do it, oh god. Yeah, what did I say about this way being foolproof again? Can somebody remind me what is my intelligence? Okay, it's not really, really high right now. Considering of the pitiful performances that we've been offering so far. So we need to wait there as long as possible. Oh my god, are you kidding me? Oh my god. Why? Rittenhouse! Well, at least I'm having fun, but oh god. I was so right when I decided to do this with unlimited lives on, because pretty much everything with which could go wrong with this update went wrong, but hey, at least they deserve to go wrong, because this level is not easy, it's really not easy. Not only this is a long level, but now there's actual challenge involved with all of this, so okay, now I'm just going to concentrate. Here we go, yes, this is how you do it. Now there's no way for this gun to get to me. Except that if I fuck up like an idiot and almost teleported back to the same thing where I went from. But alright, with that bit of knowledge being passed after something like 8 attempts? Well, not really 8, but well, what do you know, I like to exaggerate. But now it's time that we finally finish this. Alright, it's time to undergo through the Ray Gun Gauntlet for the final time. And let's hope that we're going to live through this. Now I pretty much have this all locked down. Yeah, it takes a couple of times in order to get the timing correctly at first, but once that you manage to do that, you can get through this room every single time without any slight worries. And now that we've done that, we can finally go around and complete this castle. This room really got a whole lot quieter out of a sudden. And that's it. This room just looks so much nicer and quieter now that everything is being done inside it. A good relief on a level well done. And the nicest thing about this is, once that you've got the key, well, it's not like it's a huge trek back to wherever you started. So here we go, the castle is all over. It's now time to just go back 2 rooms ago in order to enjoy our well-earned victory against this level. Even though we died way over the amount of time we should have died on this level, but hey, this level was hard. But okay, I didn't really make it that easier, but you gotta enjoy all of those flags saluting your victory against this castle. And unfortunately, we don't get to enter a high score because, well, we had infinite lives. So here we go, Rittenhouse. This is how you make a long level. Because, well, this level might have been really long, and some sections of it really were way over the line in terms of repetition, but in the end, it's still a pretty fun castle, and some of the rooms are really fun. Because, well, the ray gun gauntlet seemed like it was really a pain in the ass, but, well, if you die, it's not like you're set back a whole lot. You just need to go back 2 rooms in order to attempt it again. So, in short, I enjoyed this castle, and, well, this is one castle which is worth playing. So, it's time to let the music speak, so goodbye. See you at the next castle.